Hi guys, Frostfangs here, welcome back once again, of course, to the Paladins video. We're going to be playing some Widow today, focused around her Seedling and her Scorn talent. I did this a while ago, like a year ago. It's a pretty fun way to play her, but I haven't played it or covered it in about a year, so I thought we would revisit it. Blast Flower is still probably the best way to play her and the way that I play her the most often. After the buff to Nightshade, I'd say I see it quite a bit, but I never really find myself grabbing it. I just stick to Blast Flower or Scorn. They work a bit better for me. I have a setup for it here in the bottom left. The other two are for Dead Zone, anti-heal focused, and then the standard one. So we have reset on the Q. Whenever we hit somebody with the Q, this card is really, really strong, often underestimated because it triggers per little seedling, like the first one, and then the four that it turns into, you can trigger on each individual one, even on the same person. So technically you can throw your Q on one person, have it explode, land all four of the seedlings, and get your Q fully reset just off of one person. So it's kind of misleading here, but it does work better than you'd think. Then the rest of the build follows the same formula as all of my Willow setups, with the reset, the extra health, the damage reduction, and the ammo gen on the F. You can really see what I've done here. It's pretty straightforward to see what the differences between the three are. Of course, different setups work for different people. You might want to tweak it a little bit to your own personal taste, but for me, those three I'd consider pretty much perfect. For game one, we've got King of the Hill, Marauder's Port, we've got a Calm, we've got a Sky, we've got a Zin, and a Seris. We're up against another Willow, a Kanessa, a Fernando, a Pip, and a Sky. We'll go ahead and grab Scorn, and then the Seedling setup, of course. Willow's Recolor is one of my favorites, and I'm rocking it with the Firecracker weapon, which I think match really, really well. The reload on that is really, really nice. We'll grab Cauterize or Chronos. I guess we'll start with Chronos for the sake of the video. We've got Storm of Bullets, Debilitate, Yomi, Mortal Reach, then Blast Flower, Scorn, Reaper's Position, Smoke and Dagger, and Combat Medic. She's actually running a setup with like self-heal and ammo gen on the Seedling. I'm going to need a bit of a warm-up because I haven't played Willow in a while. We did get some decent damage there. Did tap the Sky a little bit, see if we can get a cheeky angle. I'll throw the Q, try and bounce it off there. We can F up, get a shot in a Dead Zone for the Sky. Not a Sky, a Kanessa. They're all kind of low. Get some good damage with the Q. We hit a bunch of stuff there. We'll F up, throw the Q over again. Throw the Dead Zone there as well. That should get us some good damage. I don't know how that didn't fully reset the Q, to be completely honest. That's very weird, but hey, we'll throw it over there. Get a reload in. Hello, Kanessa. There's the F. We didn't fully reload, so I'm probably gone. Can't grab to the Nando, but I think he got back on. He thought he respawned really quick. I don't know. We dropped the Q, got some damage. I'm going to just jump and go for the ult, get that extra height, throw the Dead Zone there, get some long distance shots on the Sky. That's an ult. We're getting some okay damage. We'll F'd in a little bit, get some more hits, but that freaking heal's just going to stop that Zim ult from doing anything. Throw the Q back there, try and get it behind the Nando shield, but it kind of bounced weirdly. Hello, enemy Willow. You're just going in for some sort of really weird flank play. Okay, there's a right click over there on the Kanessa. We'll throw the Q up, throw the Dead Zone just there. That's a pretty big one. That's the can't grab. I think throwing the Pip off the map, I guess we technically got the kill. That Q was massive. We got a crazy amount of damage with that. We'll go for the ult so we can drift further away. That's a whole team wipe. Well, bloody done. That actually turned out great. We'll go ahead and grab double Cauterize. I feel like I should be grabbing that even with the Dead Zone. Still makes a ton of sense. We'll throw the Q there. Dead Zone at the back. I think I'm probably dead. I'll throw the Q right in front of me. Should deal some damage to the Nando at least. We killed the Sky. We're both pretty much bang on 150. This game is really even. There goes the Nando. Any second, let me just reload real quick. There we go. We can F up, throw another Q there. Go for the ult. Kind of drift downwards. Maybe push in here on the Willow. She should be dead, right? Dead Zone, just to make sure. There we go. We'll throw a Q when it comes off cooldown. Kind of throw it up there to maybe kill the Sky. I don't know. I think she's probably fine, but we can finish her off. I probably would have been able to kill there with Blast Flower, but who knows? Lob a Q down there. Shoot a shot in a Dead Zone too. We actually got a perfect bounce with that. Kanessa's teleporting forward. I don't know if they have a Kanessa, but they're actually holding up pretty well considering they don't seem to have one. That is the Khan ulting the Fernando. He's just gone. We'll drop the Q there. That's the Pip ult again. I'm probably dead here. Why did I jump? Either way, we're okay. Why is the Kanessa bot so bad? Doesn't really do anything other than like teleport at the last second. Kind of weird. She was here at the start because she grabbed a talent and everything, but throw the Q there again. I think Seris tried to ult. I don't know. We killed the Sky. I think, again, kind of accidentally, I was aiming that at the Nando. We'll F up. There is the Sky. There's a shot and a Dead Zone. I think I'm probably dead. Maybe we can get rid of her. I'm going to try and F up. I got caught really weirdly there on the floor. Yeah, but we're dead. I was going to die there even if I didn't fall off. Let's go for some sort of vault play. Maybe we can pull something off here. We'll throw the Q there kind of behind the Fernando. I guess we can try and get rid of the Willow. Pip ulted. I'm trying to get rid of her here. She's just going to fall off. Okay, Kanessa's probably going to kill me. Maybe. But I don't know. There's a shot in a Dead Zone. There's a kill. I don't know how I didn't die. Yeah, the Kanessa definitely hasn't reconnected, so I'm not really sure what's going on, but she should be gone. We're going to F, go for the ult, get rid of this Pip here. We'll throw the Dead Zone on him. We'll drop the Q kind of back there a bit. That should guarantee it, right? Yeah, Nando's pulling up the shield, trying to get some more shots behind him. It's not really working though. His shield is now eventually gone. We'll throw that back there to lock it off. There's a Dead Zone. We'll F. Should be a team wipe, right? I don't know why this is so janky. I'm trying to trace the Sky, but I'm kind of completely failing here. She's got a pretty big heal from the Pip. Kanessa bot just waddling in, teleporting down in a way that I don't know how she even managed to do. Throw the Q there and a Dead Zone. I think I'm probably dead. We're going to get some good damage, but I'm in freaking middle of like three of them. Khan's ulting the Nando. Rip. Jesus Christ, just completely removing him from the game. Honestly, if they win this as a 45 though, I can't be mad. That's what I was trying to say. I think I might be dead. I don't know, maybe we can get rid of the Pip. Sin's ulting. That's a Willow Q. Hello, Kanessa bot. What is going on? I'm just dead. Throw the queue down there. I'm honestly not even going to try to explain what this game has been. I'm sure the stats will do a better job than I can. We'll throw the queue straight away there again. Hello, enemy Willow. You should be gone. Okay, there we go. We can F in, lob another queue, shoot the dead zone as well. That was a bad idea. I thought there was more people with me. 397, 398, 399, and there is the defeat. Fair play. Can't even be mad at that one. They were a man down for most of the game with the Knessa not being there, but they still managed to pull through. And there we go. I feel like I did fine. I definitely could have done better. A lot of the deaths there were avoidable. I wasn't playing very smart or really safe at all, but 115k, I'm pretty happy with that. Ceres did pretty good. Zin had a bit of a hard time there though. Sky was also not playing the best ever. Their Nando did pretty good. Their Pip was actually really, really solid. He was kind of shredding. I don't think we had that much anti-heal, to be honest. Didn't feel like we did. Their Willow and their Knessa weren't doing all that much, and then their Sky was doing pretty good, but I reckon they won that just from the objective. Their Nando was playing it as much as he possibly could, whereas nobody on our side really was. Khan was just doing his own thing. For game two, we've got Onslaught Archives. Shoutouts to Khan, BK, and possibly RIO. We then have a Tyra there as well, and for their side, a Makoa, a Koga, a BK, a Damba, and a Vora. So I went ahead and grabbed the exact same thing we went for in the first one. Raw Subjects, Storm Bullets, and Skill Ghost's Blessing on Yielding Pressure. Raw Subjects, Pluck, and Adrenaline Junkie, then Ripened Gourd. We'll throw our Q straight off the bat and a Dead Zone. That was a terrible play. Nobody even ran on that bit, but Makoa ran straight round, and seems like most of them did. Khan somehow didn't die there. See if we can finish off this Koga. Should be a free one as long as I don't suck. Yeah, there we go. Drop the Q there. I might be dead. I'm going to try and dip. We'll throw the Dead Zone and then just F away. We're actually still out of combat. And then Makoa, you're kind of behind everybody for some reason. I don't know why I thought the right click would put you into combat. Obviously, it only deals damage if you hit somebody. We'll throw the Q there. We'll F back this way. That should be a pretty big Q. Nice. That was some solid damage. Dead Zone here on the four. We actually counter her really hard. We'll throw the Q over there. Went ahead and popped the ult. Koga went for his. We'll throw the Q there. Kind of in the middle. Throw a little shot or two over that little corner. BK just set himself flying. Vor was still sat in the corner. BK didn't even see her. And she should be gone. Even if I don't hit her, maybe the Q will do it. Oh my god, she's on nothing. Don't know if I'd recommend this way of playing Willow. If you were, you know, tryharding and you wanted to really win a game, you wanted to have like the best stats ever. Khan just trying to throw the Makoa off. Yeah, she still got him there. Damba ulted, didn't hit anybody. That was kind of weird. Hello, Koga. I'm going to throw the Q kind of on the left and force you to go right. Okay, there we go. I think that Damba has DC'd, but in tryhard stuff, you usually want to be as reliable as possible. And this is very, very bursty. And if you throw it and don't get anything from it, then your whole setup is doing not that much for you other than like the sustain side of things. So for casuals, works great. For tryhard, not so much. Four is going to go ahead and remove me. My Q didn't even kill her there, but I guess Tyra finished off, so it's whatever. At least in my opinion, it's pretty much a prime example of a casual setup. It works fine, like I said, in tryhard ones, but in casuals, I feel like it's going to really do work. We'll throw the Dead Zone there, finish off the Makoa. He's just dropping the emote. He knows he's a goner. It's kind of an unfair one, to be honest. There, Maldamba isn't here. I think he was here at the start, and then DC'd, similar to in the last one. I think the BK might have also left, like, at some point. I don't know. There goes Vora. We're going to win this regardless. Doesn't even really matter what I do. We'll finish it off with a TDM, though. I won't cut the video here because we've had two kind of mid games. Koga went for the ult. Hello, Makoa. He's going to retreat. I think BK just ulted. I have no idea, but he's gone. Maybe that BK is here. I have no idea. I just tried to F and got stunned. Doesn't matter. There is the victory. Luna's just dying there in the middle. I guess Luna dies when you win. That's something I've never noticed before, but yeah, we'll do game three. I'm not going to really go over the stats because, again, it was a 4v5. There they are. If you wanted to see them, shoutouts to the team again, of course. We'll jump into a game three quickly, though, to hopefully close out the video in a game where there isn't a disconnect. For the third one, we've got TDM Dragon Arena. Shoutouts to our Lux. We then have a Dredge, a Vatu, and a Vorum. We're up against an Andro, a Ruckus, a Moji, a Grok, and an Amani. Throw the Q there towards the middle. Wouldn't usually go for the Q setup here just because of the team comps. You're better off going for it in a situation where there's an objective or people who can't easily dodge it. There's a Dead Zone for the Amani. She is out. We've got Discovery, Relentless Presence, Abyss Spike, Unearing. I was going to call that Retribution. Boom, boom, Splitting Ice, Totemic Rocket Barrage, and then the last one, which I missed. There's a Dead Zone right on the middle for him and a couple little pokes. What is the last one? Curse of War. For some reason, I always forget the name of that one. Throw a Dead Zone over there again. Just direct hit the Ruckus. Kind of leave that Dead Zone floating in the middle. We'll F up to the top. There goes the Amani. For some reason, I'm just dealing like a last little bit of damage to her every single time. Couple little taps there for the Grok. He's ghost walking early. Guess we can push in here, get rid of him. There's a Dead Zone. He is out. I just took a mad amount of damage from that Inferno cannon. It is getting a slight nerf in the next update, but Jesus Christ, that burst was brutal. Bounce the Q there off the wall because I know they are there. We got some damage on them earlier. That's actually a free double. We got rid of the Andro too. I didn't even know the Amani was there. I was aiming that at like the Moji, but Moji retreated. So hey, I'll take a free double. If that doesn't show you how freaking strong the setup can be, I don't know what would. The team is honestly putting in mad work here. I did get some damage on the Amani. Shouts team there for the save. She managed to just about not melt me. We'll throw the Q over. I'm just gonna wait here and heal up. You can actually see kind of through that a little bit. She's gliding round. Do we F up to meet her? She actually went round those. I couldn't even get rid of her. There's some shots on the Grok. We'll go for the ult. Get that little jump height. If you time it well, you can get a lot of momentum with that. Drop the Q down there. I think I'm probably dead any second. We're gonna F, get back on, but that's not enough ammo. He's just gonna punch me to finish. How rude. I think the Amani he just spawned. There goes the Grok, just through the queue on the left side. I don't know if anybody else got him low, if we just completely bursted him, but that's again another very, very free kill. I wasn't even looking in the direction where he died. He just respawned over there. We're going to go for blast shields. Definitely looking forward to when you no longer have to make that decision and you just grab damage reduction and Ray being in the game. That'll be fun. I threw the Q, but that's not going to get me anything. Throw the Q down. There's a shot in a dead zone. Force him to kind of stick to the left, trying to hit him mid-air, but my accuracy is crap. And Mindlex gave me a hand and we landed one. He's out. We'll throw the Q over there for the dead zone over two. Hello, Grok. A little tap or two. Try and stay out of range. So we'd have used his ghost walk. So I guess we just have to try and finish him off. I don't have my dead zone. And Marnie's just stood there. She's going for the ult. I'm just going to throw the Q and run. Okay. Thank you for the free one, I guess. Didn't get the full reset. She's now just respawned in the same spot pretty much. We're going to F up. I think I'm dead. Even if I landed all of those, I wouldn't have enough time. But Lex killed her anyway, though. So it's whatever. We'll grab some more Haven. Go for the ult. I feel like they put some work in to make the ult feel a little bit less janky, because I feel like I carry that momentum way easier now than you used to. I feel like it's just a little bit easier to make it feel the right way. We're going to F in here. Throw the Q down. I was just trying to dead zone, but it was on cooldown. We'll throw another one. Again, really showing the strength of the reset. Managed to just about clip the Grok. Andrew's going for the ult. We'll throw that Q under him and hide behind a rock. Yeah, sure. I think I've only died to Amani so far, actually. Never mind, now I died to Andrew once. Don't know if that's even true, but I just feel like the only times I died in that game were to the Amani right click. She was just gliding around using it a ton and getting pretty damn good damage with it. That was a pretty straightforward win, like 40 to 20 or something like that. Team did a really good job. Again, there are the stats if you're interested. Shout outs to the Lex. And yeah, there we go. That was Willow with the seedling setup. I feel like it actually went pretty well. The games we had weren't the best ever, but I did demonstrate the burst with it and the reset. Although sometimes this card didn't seem to trigger reliably. Sometimes it gave me full reset when I feel like it shouldn't have. And other times where it hit like 8 people, it seemed like it didn't reset it for me. So I have a feeling that this one is kind of broken or bugged. It definitely works differently than most people think that it works, but I also don't think it does that reliably. I don't know. If anybody wants to put in the time to like really thoroughly test it, let me know. And yeah, thank you for watching. If like if you enjoyed, of course, let me know what you want to see me do next. I'll see you guys all really, really soon. And as always, stay frosty.